Hello, Your Politics. Today I'm heading to a solidarity rally. A local cinema, the Ritzy in Brixton, has had four union representatives sacked. Their crime? Campaigning for a living wage for the workers of the Ritzy. The Ritzy is part of Picture House, which is in turn owned by Cineworld. Now, Cineworld makes multi-million pounds profit every year, so they can afford to pay their workers a decent wage. So I'm heading to the cinema to stand in solidarity with those union reps, as well as stand up for workers' rights in general. Let's go.
Remind anyone who's going into the cinema, this cinema refuses to pay its staff the London Living Wage, and when its staff request to be paid the London Living Wage, they do not meet with them, they do not discuss that demand with them. Instead, what this cinema does is sack four trade union representatives.
Well, thanks very much indeed for inviting me here today, and I bring the solidarity from the Labour Party to this incredibly worthwhile campaign that you are engaged in today. This decision to sack trade unionists must not be allowed to stand. It is an offence against decency to sack people who are standing up for the rights of ordinary working people. It seems as if the company who owns Ritzy, Cineworld, want to take us back to a Victorian era. We know that this is where the government want to take the country with the Trade Union Act and the various measures that they brought and put in place to undermine the role of trade unions. And it's no coincidence that the consistent attacks on the trade union movement over the last four decades have led to a situation where pay in this country is falling backwards, unlike any other workforce anywhere else in the developed world who've seen significant pay rises over the last 7 or 8 years since the crash took place. And that's why I'm here today, to show our solidarity with you. And when we stand together, we're strong. And that's what the Labour movement's about. Unity is strength. And I'll finish with just a quote from Percy Shelley's poem, which will be a rallying cry to all of us. Rise like lions after slumber, in unvanquishable number. Shake your chains to earth like dew, which in sleep have fallen on you. Ye are many, they are few. Solidarity, comrades.
So I'm here with Labour MP Chris Williamson. Chris, at the moment, workers' rights is in flux. So on one side, you've got things like the McDonald's strikes, this strike by the Ritzy, you've got Labour championing, you know, socialist policies that champion workers' rights. But on the other side, you've got these exploitative companies, you've got the repeal bill, which threatens to tear down those workers' rights. What is your opinion on the state of workers' rights at the moment, and what can we do?
Well, workers' rights are in a parlous state at the moment, but what is incredibly encouraging for me and millions of other people who think like I do, is that workers are beginning to find their strength again, beginning to recognise and remember that unity is strength. And that's why we're seeing disputes like this. We're seeing the strike at McDonald's, which is beginning to bear fruit. And of course, we're seeing huge support for Jeremy Corbyn. One of the cornerstones of Jeremy's policy agenda, which is now mainstream Labour Party policy, is to repeal the anti-trade union legislation, to reintroduce collective bargaining rights, and to, you know, give people the right to be able to join a trade union once again. The mood has really shifted now. Yes, you know, workers are up against it in a number of workplaces like Ritzy here today, but I think change is just around the corner. And with a Labour government committed to significant change in the way in which we organise the economy, the way in which we give workers their rights once again, I think we'll start to see very rapid change and workers once again being able to, you know, join a trade union and actually enjoy the wealth of this country. Britain is the fifth richest nation on the planet, but inequality has risen every single year for almost the last 40 years, and we've got to change that. And the way in which we're going to do that is by giving trade unions the ability to organise again. When we do that, workers will see an improvement in their living standards, increases in wages, and that will be not only beneficial for those workers themselves, but will be beneficial right across the whole economy. Because if you put money into the pockets of ordinary working people, they'll tend to spend it, and that creates an economic virtuous circle, because they spend it in the real economy on goods and services, which helps to sustain other jobs. A Labour government is absolutely key, but even without that, I believe that the trade union movement is finding its feet again and will win battles, but getting a Labour government led by Jeremy Corbyn is going to be pivotal to making that massive sea change that we need to see.
Thanks, Chris.
Cheers, mate. All the best.
Take care.
Good luck. Bye. Cheers.
So I found it really inspiring to see people coming out here and lending their voices to the cause. Coming out here and telling these companies that it's not good enough. When people come out here and show solidarity with the workers, they're telling the companies, they're telling Parliament, they're telling the MPs that workers' rights have to be upheld, that scrapping workers' rights is not acceptable. That's it for today. If you like this video, hit the like button, smash the subscribe button, and leave your comments below. Until next time, stay safe and stay engaged.